The Kenyan woman has offered strong leadership throughout our country's changing history. Even before colonization, women were defying all odds to offer incredible leadership to their communities. The folklore of many traditional communities exhibits examples of notable women leaders who defied patriarchal structures to offer successful political leadership for their people. Chief Wangu wa Makeri, famous for her appointment as the headman of Waithega location in 1901, is among the first group of female trailblazers in a largely patriarchal society. She was the only headman during the colonial period. But she was not alone. As Kenya fiercely battled the colonial era, notable women were on the front lines of the struggle for independence. Mekatilili wa Menza led the Giriama uprising against British rule. Abagusi medicine woman Mora Mokangiti led an anti-British movement in Gusiland. And we all remember Priscilla Abuao, the only woman in the Kenyan delegation at Lancaster House. Despite these facets of strong female leaders, women still had many barriers to break. After independence, it became clear just how high the glass ceiling was for women. In fact, the Kenyan Parliament between 1963 and 1969 did not even have a single woman member of Parliament. Along the way, pioneer women slowly shattered the prejudices holding women back and gradually paved way for more women leaders to come into modern politics. Chief among them was Honorable Grace Onyango, the first woman elected to Parliament in 1969. Her legacy in Parliament is marked by legendary debating skill, temporary service as Deputy Speaker of the House, and her defining role in the investigation of the murder of MP John Kariuki of Nyandarua North. Professor Julia Ojiambo was the first female MP from the then Western Province. After clinching the Funyula seat, she added another feather to her hat by becoming the first female assistant minister in Kenya. Honorable Chelagat Mutai was the youngest MP, joining the August House at only 24 years old to represent Eldoret North constituency. She remains the youngest elected woman parliamentarian in Kenya's history. In 1974, Honorable Nyiva Mwendwa became the first woman to be elected as MP for Kitui West. She worked for 2 decades before being appointed Culture and Social Services Minister, the first woman cabinet minister. As the first woman parliamentarian to serve 2 terms, Dr. Phoebe Asiyo had her fair share of firsts. First African woman to become senior superintendent in Kenyan prisons, the pioneer to sponsor the affirmative action motion in Parliament in 1997. But even as these women trailblazers kick-started important milestones for the Kenyan woman, still a lot of work remained. Although Honorable Phoebe Asiyo's first motion on affirmative action for women representation in elective office was unsuccessful in 1997, Honorable Beth Muga's second bid in 2002 sailed through. In the 1990s, more women were fighting for a wider political space, and the achievements were crystal clear. Women's representation in the national parliament increased over time. This led to landmark legislations and measures that addressed the gender inequality. The National Gender Equality Commission was established. There was now a ministry in charge of women affairs, children, and social services. A presidential directive for 30% women representation in public service. The Women's Fund and National Gender Affirmative Action Fund were established. The Sexual Offences Act was published. Over the years, a few courageous women have also put their names on the ballot for the highest office in Kenya. Honorable Charity Ngilu was the first woman to run for president, leaving a lasting mark in female leadership. Professor Wangari Maathai, first woman in East and Central Africa to earn a PhD, ran for the presidency in 1997 and became the first African woman to receive the Nobel Peace Prize in recognition for her tireless struggle to promote democracy, human rights, and environmental protection. And in the most recent elections, Honorable Martha Karua also threw her hat in the ring and ran for the top seat. Although we are yet to see a woman president in Kenya, the 2010 constitution opened up more opportunities for the Kenyan woman. The law requires equal treatment of all Kenyans, regardless of their gender. This means that women are granted the right to equal opportunities politically, economically, socially, and culturally. Sexual discrimination is outlawed. And more importantly, it requires that at least a third of all elective and appointive positions go to women. But implementing these new provisions has not been a walk in the park. In the run-up to the 2013 election, women faced yet another hurdle. The legislation required to facilitate the two-thirds gender rule was never enacted, and in the end, the threshold was never met. Women legislators in the 11th Parliament were still able to move critical policies. At the National Assembly and the Senate, women leaders have focused on governance, the nation's development, uplifting the lives of marginalized communities, women, youth, and persons living with disabilities. Currently, 17 bills by women are at different stages in both houses. With the many challenges that women leaders face, it is still an uphill battle for women to fully participate in the political process.
It is not that easy. And for a woman who is young, you have to work twice as hard for half the recognition.
Our culture cannot allow women to vie for any seat.
People don't believe that people with disabilities can deliver.
Blackmailing. Propagandas are up and almost every day.
Finance is also a big challenge to us.
It's time. Juggling between being a corporate person, politics, being a young mother and a wife, it's a huge challenge.
The media stereotyping that you cannot be a woman and a leader, you know. You are already profiled to be a woman first. And they don't see you as a leader.
Recognizing these hurdles, USAID and DFID is supporting the initiative dubbed the List of 5,000 Women Aspirants, with the goal of building the confidence of women vying for public office, enhancing their capacity to effectively compete, and raising their visibility. The project seeks to encourage more political participation by women and promote dialogue on ways to reduce barriers to their participation. Through targeted trainings, the women are learning
of political strategy.
To manage myself as a political aspirant.
How to manage my resources.
The importance of the media.
How to speak with confidence.
The management of finance.
And resource mobilization.
The List of 5,000 initiative brings together a network of like-minded organizations to support female aspirants. National Democratic Institute and the Kenyan Women Parliamentarian Association are providing skills-building training and mentorship, while Kenya Women Holding, through its Tuvuke initiative, is working to enhance public support of female leaders. Women Empowerment Link promotes women leadership through advocacy. All this is to promote the efforts by Kenyan women in political leadership, because women's leadership means...
Consider it.
Better decision makers.
If you build a woman, you are building the nation.
You empower the community. And you're first a leader, then your gender comes in.
As the 2017 elections approach, the game changer will be pegged on the multiplicity of efforts and strategies applied to ensure that the richness women can bring to the political arena are no longer dreams, but realities. As a nation, we made the decision in 2010 to guarantee women an opportunity to participate in the political leadership of this country. The time is now for political parties and all Kenyans to fully support women and value their contribution. Chagua Dada, Jenga Nchi.